Latter-day Trumpet. This is a Latter-day Trumpet presentation that is an exciting new video about the Book of Mormon. There are many church scholars that believe that the Lehi Colony landed in South America. This series of videos reflect those ideas and theories and should not be considered as official church doctrine. The Many Days of Nephi by L. Norman Shurtleff. The Many Days of the Prophet Nephi. The description of the term many days is fundamental to our discovery of the geography in the Book of Mormon lands of South America. Since we know that the Lehi Colony landed on the west coast of Chile at the 30th parallel, then the term many days becomes paramount to our discussion. Nephi says that he and his family traveled many days from their first inheritance, Lehi's landing place, to their eventual city of Nephi. This video will try to logically define this important term, many days, for us in our quest for discovery of the truths from the Book of Mormon. We must first start with a little scriptural and historical background from their journey to the Promised Land to put in perspective Nephi's later commentary in 2 Nephi after they had safely reached their destination, the city of Nephi. Finally, after a long journey, they reached the land Bountiful after much trial and tribulation. Here's a map of their proposed travels around the Arabian Peninsula. Nephi says simply, "And we did sojourn for the space of many years, yea, even 8 years, in the wilderness." It took Nephi and his family 8 long years to travel 2,500 miles around the Arabian Peninsula. Some days they probably made good progress, maybe 10 to 20 miles per day. They obviously had to stop and rest a lot as well because of birthing mothers, little children, burying their dead, and hunting, etc. This map, after 8 exhausting years. Building a ship. In the land Bountiful, the leadership situation changed considerably because the Lord commands Nephi to build a ship. It's interesting that the Lord asked Nephi to build the ship at this point and not his father Lehi. The prophet Lehi would have been much older by then, and the Lord undoubtedly needed Nephi's useful strength and energy for the project. And it came to pass that after I, Nephi, had been in the land of Bountiful for the space of many days, the voice of the Lord came unto me, saying, "Arise, and get thee into the mountain." And it came to pass that I arose, and went up into the mountain, and cried unto the Lord. The key words that Nephi uses in his account here are "for the space of many days." We will see later in this video that Nephi uses these same words to describe the length of time his family traveled into the wilderness to find and establish the city of Nephi. Ocean voyage to the Promised Land. And again, Nephi uses the term many days twice more to describe the length of time they sailed on their journey to the Promised Land. "We put forth into the sea, and were driven forth before the wind, towards the Promised Land. And after we had been driven forth before the wind for the space of many days, behold," and Nephi goes on and continues. This account was presumably written many years later, after Nephi was living happily in his new land, possibly even 30 years later. So it is interesting that he is so specific as to his references of time. On the oceanic journey, his brothers and their wives made themselves merry and offended God. Nephi was taken captive. The compass ceased working, and a great storm drove them back for 3 days. The boat was then, on the fourth day, nearly swallowed up in the depths of the sea. Because of the fear of death, they loosed Nephi of his bonds, and he was able to direct the ship with the aid of the Liahona once again to the Promised Land. "And it came to pass that after we had sailed for the space of many days, we did arrive at the Promised Land." Here is a map of the ocean currents and the possible route to the Promised Land. He used the term many days twice on the voyage, once before the storm and once after the storm. Many scholars have suggested that the ocean voyage took the family of Lehi approximately a year. It also took the brother of Jared and the Jaredite group a similar amount of time, though their routes were most likely very different. Many days. The term many days is used by Nephi several times in his writing. Where there are short periods of days that can be counted, he is very specific to count the days for us. If it is a long period of time, of more than a year in length, Nephi is very specific in the number of years. Trying to put the time period, many days, into a more specific amount of time is difficult, because each time he used this term, the length of time he referred to was probably a little bit different. However, it can be suggested that many days was probably at least 170 to 200 days. We know that when Lehi's family got to the land Bountiful, they planted their seeds and then would have harvested their crops before they boarded their new ship, so that they would have had fresh provisions for their ocean voyage. It would have taken at least 120 days for those crops to mature, especially grain crops. At first, Nephi would have been preoccupied with planting and nurturing his crop before he would take time to build the boat. 170 days before the storm incident on the ocean crossing, and approximately 170 days after the storm, would satisfy somewhat the time interval of many days if the crossing took almost a year. The Promised Land. When Lehi's family got to the Promised Land, Lehi immediately gave thanks to the Lord. They established themselves in the Promised Land and pitched their tents, and again planted their seeds and cultivated their crops for a season. The landing area north of Santiago, Chile, at Coquimbo, is arid and dry, but the hill country and valleys leading up into the Andean mountain ranges are fertile, with many rivers to irrigate the crops. Some of the best fruit orchards and vegetable gardens in South America can be found in this region. Lehi grew old and blessed his children and grandchildren before he died. After the death of the family patriarch, as so often happens, the unity and cohesiveness of the family disappeared, and Nephi and his followers were forced to flee into the wilderness for their safety. The journey to the city of Nephi. Nephi, or Manco Capac, then began his epic journey into the wilderness that has been chronicled by the rememberers in the legend, probably between 590 to 585 BC. Nephi says that they took their belongings and journeyed for many days into the wilderness. Previously, it was suggested a time period of about 170 to 200 days journey was equivalent to the term many days, averaging some 10 to 20 miles per day maximum with provisions and presumably small children would be a difficult journey. This would be even more difficult if the terrain was uphill, mountainous, and with no roads or maps, especially carrying all of your possessions and provisions with you. Tending herds and hunting for food and water along the way would have slowed their progress as well. If they traveled approximately 24 to 29 weeks, or 170 to 200 day time estimate, as our many days definition allows, then they probably could have traveled between 600 to 1450 miles if they traveled an average of 5 days a week and had 2 rest days a week. The direction of travel, according to our map, was northward and into the mountainous regions of the Andes, leaving or escaping Laman and Lemuel, the Lamanites, and their original settlements in the land southward on the Pacific coast of Chile, had to be done quickly. Nephi and his little band most likely stayed along the coast to begin with as they went north. This would have given them their best advantage to quickly distance themselves from the Lamanites, who would be following after them. Eventually, they would turn east and climb up into the Andes and the Lake Titicaca region. Today, this proposed route for Nephi from Coquimbo, Chile to Cusco, Peru, our proposed location of the city of Nephi, is just over 1,000 miles. This distance could definitely be done within the many days scenario of our theory. Therefore, Nephi in the scriptures limits and defines the distances himself in the narration of the events that he has given to us. However, to imagine that the state of New York could be accessed from the original landing, some 7,000 miles distance, within Nephi's description of the events is impossible. Remember that the Nephite party sent out by King Limhi from the city of Nephi in search of Zarahemla were lost for many days, searching the land northward. They saw the areas of the Jaredite destruction and found the record of Ether. This is the same area, presumably, where the Hill Cumorah and the final Nephite battle took place. If Nephi would have traveled further north into the wilderness, Then he would have told us how many years it took instead of using the many days term. He was well familiar already with their 8-year, 2,500-mile trek in the wilderness across the deserts of the Arabian Peninsula. Travel from First Inheritance to the City of Nephi. Nephi relates the following about their journey into the wilderness. And we did take our tents, and whatsoever things were possible for us, and did journey in the wilderness for the space of many days. And after we had journeyed for the space of many days, we did pitch our tents, and my people would that we should call the name of the place Nephi. Wherefore, we did call it Nephi. Nephi made no mistake here in his chronology. They only traveled a distance of many days to get to his land of Nephi. He would eventually build the city of Nephi and a temple to God. Garcilaso de la Vega, a Spanish chronicler, whose father was a conquistador and his mother an Inca princess, wrote that Manco Capac and his sister wife, between them, taught the people the arts and industries. He instructed the men in agriculture and introduced the laws of the society. She taught the women to spin and weave, the Book of Mormon says of the followers of the prophet Nephi. And we did observe to keep the judgments and the statutes and the commandments of the Lord in all things, according to the law of Moses. And the Lord was with us, and we did prosper exceedingly, for we did sow seed, and we did reap again in abundance. And we began to raise flocks and herds and animals of every kind. And I did teach my people to build buildings, and to work in all manner of wood, and of iron, and of copper, and of brass, and of steel, and of gold, and of silver, and of precious ores, which were in great abundance. And it came to pass that I, Nephi, did cause my people to be industrious, and to labor with their hands. Nephi and the City of Nephi. Nephi writes very little more about the land or his travels during the last years of his life. We know that Nephi died 55 years after they left Jerusalem, 600 BC, in about 545 BC, or about at the age of 70 years. So, being in the wilderness for 8 years, and then in Bountiful for months, crossing the ocean for a year, and traveling to the city of Nephi, all account for probably at least 10 years. Most likely, this would leave the prophet Nephi 45 years to build his city and temple in the land of Nephi. Of course, one can imagine that such great prophet would build a great civilization. We also know that Nephi was a righteous prophet and king. He would not have subjected his people to burdensome taxes or labor to complete facilities that were not needed or important to their survival. And Nephi would only build according to the resources at his disposal. He had limited manpower when they first arrived in the city of Nephi. Labor to build buildings, irrigation canals, fortresses, and etc. would have been modest, to say the least. However, we can rightly suggest that many projects and buildings were at least started, and cities and highways planned during the days of Nephi. The actual grandeur of the city in the land of Nephi would have progressed throughout the Nephite 450-year occupation of the land of Nephi. However, the temple that Nephi built was a priority, and he says that it was built after the manner of construction of the Temple of Solomon. We know of no other building in South America that so closely describes Nephi's temple as the Temple of Coricancha in Cusco, Peru. In conclusion, the term many days defines the geography of the Book of Mormon for all of us. We must conclude that since Lehi's landing in Chile gives a focal point to the Americas, and then Nephi and his group of followers never left the Andean highlands. The many days description limits his travel to approximately 1,000 miles and to exactly the location of the historically sacred capital of the Chavín or Inca civilization, Cusco, Peru. The imperial capital of the Incas is the most sacred city in all of South America, and it is shaped in the form of a puma, or mountain lion. The Temple of Coricancha is located in its center. It is the navel of the puma, and still to this day, this temple that Nephi built is considered the most sacred place in all of South America. Thanks to this great prophet king Nephi, and his perfectly written scriptural account, and his term many days, we can put a physical location to the Book of Mormon. It is the most correct book ever written. It is a marvelous work and wonder of God in these, the latter days.